paleo, if this guy attacks, he's unaffected by everything. So he's like Star Eater. Like, you just literally can't touch him in the battle. He's like a battle god, but there's only one god. So I take that back. He's like just a battle master. And when you use your ulti Apeleo, your baby Apeleo on him, he does wear out because he makes himself unaffected by all card effects, which is kind of sad. So you can never actually use his effect and attack for 32. So it's kind of sad. But he is at 26. So he can beat over anything that's, you know, 26 or less. And it does help. There's a lot of 2,500 boss monsters out there. In addition to that, he kills floaters like Yang Zings. If he attacks... No, I'm sorry. I'm mixing up card effects. He's unaffected, but it doesn't say your opponent cannot activate cards or effects. I'm mixing him up with Armades, so I apologize for that. But he is very, very powerful. He helps for your game pushes. And basically, if you, this guy is on field and he's attacking over back row, like, there's nothing your opponent can do. So you're getting that damage, that push for damage no matter what. So it's really, really clutch to make him in battle phase off of your Ritual Beast Bond, like attack, contact fuse for him with Bond. If your opponent has no response to Bond, you got game right there. So he helps you a lot for your pushes, and he's pretty darn strong. Two copies of Ulti Pedalfin. Like, I have stalled out with this card, putting it at 3,300 defense. Masterpiece cannot attack over it. You know, they have to try to use the Draco Trap to have. This guy, like, this chick, she literally cannot be destroyed by card effects. So she already herself is like a wall. She's basically like a staller. I play two of her because you need extra names because you play Rampangu, and Rampangu will send one of these and, like, one of these. There are games that I only resolve Rampangu once, so I, like, send one Pedalfin and then send the baby, but you have to play multiples of something for Rampangu. Even though you can actually return them to your extra deck with Daigatsu Emerald, you still have to play multiples. And the absolute best card of this archetype is Ulti Kanahat. This dude is so skillful and powerful. This guy makes this deck insane. If they ban him, I really wouldn't feel the same about this deck. But he's so powerful, even at one. You just have to be very, very careful because he is at one. And this deck kind of has a bad matchup if you're playing True King Dinos and they banish your extra deck. Because if they know what this deck does, they're going to banish this. They're definitely going to banish, like, these two. And then, you know, it's like, dang, you knew what I was doing. And then one misses Radiant to sum up the extra deck because your Zoo combo pretty much makes this for free. In addition to that, it allows you to have your ulti fusions and then, like, a Zoo, like, Drydent. Or you can have, like, Daigatsu Emerald and Drydent. Just really, really cool. I like it a lot. And then other cards that I would be main decking. As you guys notice, I don't play D-Fissure or Macro. Now, one of the main reasons is because I'm playing Zoo. Although I'm playing a small engine of Zoos, I don't ever want to banish my Zoos. In addition to that, while these are great because they help out your Ritual Beast to banish, the Ritual Beasts already do the job that these cards do a lot better. So they're basically active floodgates that would not hurt the deck at all. So it makes sense to play them because it's like, you play them and it doesn't hurt you, but it hurts your opponent. But I chose not to play them because there's space in my deck for other cards. And I did not want to play an extreme stun-based control deck. It is extremely stun-based because I have all the back row, like all the answers. But it's more combo-oriented, as I said, than, you know, most Ritual Beast builds are. So that's how I like it. So these are kind of cards I can either side deck or I will put them in the future. But I wanted to show them in this video to show you guys that I'm not an idiot and I know that you can play these cards in the deck so that nobody hits in the comment section like, oh, this retarded douchebag isn't playing D-Fissure Macro. I have them and I can play them if I want to. It's my deck. I'm just doing something different. Breakthrough skill. I wanted to play this card at 3, but the strikes are a lot better. I want to get this deck to a point where I can play triple strike and double breakthrough because breakthrough is just a really, really good trap. I like it. The Wind, the Apeleo, these might come into the deck in the future. Double Time Space, this is something I was considering because I really hate Conductor. He summons himself from hand. And everything, like all the extra deck plays, like even Zoos, even though you shuffle it, it's like you get rid of the problem. Playing against like Lynx and playing against, what are they called? Lightsworns, what are they called? Just like there's so many decks that this trap actually hits and it's really good. I know some people could say this isn't good, but like, when this trap was good, a lot of people weren't really playing it like that. It was more like a side deck thing, but I always thought this was a powerful trap. And because this deck has space for so much back row, originally, if I didn't go for the Zoo build, I'm basically showing you guys everything I would run. Lost Wind, I would play probably multiples of Lost Wind because it's good, and Floodgate Trap Hole. So think of it this way. If I wasn't playing Zodiac Ritual Beast, I would literally just be playing these cards and having a control-based deck. Like, that's the three barrages, that's the two rapiers, that's the two whiptails. Does it make sense? I would literally just take out the Zoo engine for these cards and make the deck more control, but also a bit more boring and slower. Like, it would